Good morning, everyone. I'm Rich Bichan, one of the associate directors with the Combined Federal Campaign for Zone 28 with a very special message for you. It's that time once again to show some love to those in need throughout our local community, across the nation, and around the world. Today, October 7th, marks the opening of our local zone for the 2020 Combined Federal Campaign. You and your colleagues have the opportunity through January 15th to be the face of change by donating to a cause area that you are most passionate about. By volunteering, whether in person or virtually, with the CFC charity of your choice, or engaging in the CFC-supported activity. Are you wondering where to begin? We have a fantastic brand new Ohio CFC website, ohiocfc.givecfc.org, where you will find a great wealth of information on the 2020 campaign, as well as opportunities to engage with the CFC community. Find great tools and resources to help you make a difference in 2020. Lastly, I want to sincerely thank you on behalf of the entire Ohio CFC family and myself for all of the efforts that you have put in so far and the hard work you will be putting in over the next several months to show some love and be the face of change in the 2020 Combined Federal Campaign. We thank you and look forward to working with you to make your events a success for your agency. Now, please take a moment as we honor the flag of our great nation with the singing of the national anthem by Malia Emma and the presentation of the colors by the United States Marine Corps.
Oh, say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proud gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming.
Good morning. Ana Venduras is the Executive Director of the Federal Executive Board. Prior to her appointment as the Executive Director, she worked for the Defense, Finance, and Accounting Service for 30 years, serving as an attorney advisor for 20 years, and as a manager in finance operation for 10 years. When not working for DFAS, she volunteers extensively in the community by sitting on numerous boards and volunteering for various agencies. She has a history of volunteering with the CFC, having served as both the agency's chair and a key worker for DFAS. Ladies and gentlemen, Anna Vendouris.
Hi, everyone. I am Anna Vendouris, Director of the Cleveland Federal Executive Board, as well as Chair for the Ohio Local Federal Coordinating Committee that oversees the Ohio Combined Federal Campaign. It's that time of year again. Time to show some love to people in need in our local community, across the nation, and around the world. Each of us serves our greater community, our nation, and our world. Every year, our generous contributions through the Combined Federal Campaign further the impact charities have throughout our communities. As global challenges directly affect us locally and nationally, the need for our support has never been greater. Thousands of vetted, trusted charities that take part in the CFC rely on our support. Programs and services they offer provide a vast range of causes that benefit us all year round, including those that provide support for our military members, military families, and veterans, meeting increased demand for food, shelter, and striving to eradicate poverty, ensuring park systems are accessible, and making strides for clean air, affording adoption services for orphaned animals, providing medical research, mental and physical health care, and elder care, addressing public and societal benefits, striving to ensure our children are safe, healthy, and educated, ensuring cultural attractions remain available. Each contribution is immeasurable and valuable far beyond the dollar amount. In today's environment, we know an increased number of individuals seek support and benefit from the programs and services provided by CFC-approved charities. This year's theme is Be the Face of Change. I invite you to join me in support of this year's CFC. Our collective contributions do make a difference. Some charities also have volunteer opportunities available regardless if you contribute financially. Please visit givecfc.org to search for CFC charities, to contribute, and to learn more about volunteer opportunities. Thank you.
Thank you, Anna Vendouris, for those inspiring words. Hello again. At this time, we would like to share with you one of the videos that we hope will help you open your heart and get you in the mood to be the face of change. Our first charity is the Mid-Ohio Food Bank, located in Columbus, Ohio. Please welcome Mr. Matt Habash, President and CEO, Mid-Ohio Food Collective.
Our work has changed in some major ways since the onset of COVID, though some things haven't changed. We're still connecting our neighbors who are struggling to nutritious food, just like we have done for the past 40 years. We are getting more food in and getting more food out than ever before, serving thousands of new customers who have never visited a food pantry in their lifetime until now. Because of your incredible generosity and our amazing partner agency network, we're able to continue to meet the increased need in our communities. Thank you. We could not do this important work without you.
What a great story Matt and his team have. COVID is still affecting many lives throughout our great state. The Mid-Ohio Food Bank is on the front lines taking care of all Ohioans. Our second charity is Almost Home Dog Rescue of Ohio, located in Dublin. What a great organization. Don't you just love dogs? Back to you, Carol.
I met our next speaker during last year's combined federal campaign. He came on board with the United States Postal Service in 2006 after serving 5 years in the United States Marine Corps. He is serving as a loan executive for this year's campaign. He is also an instructor for letter carriers in the Cleveland area. His passion for medically fragile children and higher education came about after the unexpected and tragic death of his 2-year-old twin daughter, Marissa. He is a second-year doctoral student at Liberty University School of Business, where he is studying to further his nonprofit and to educate people about congenital heart defects while advocating for medically fragile children and their families. Without further delay, I present to you Mr. Mitchell Rivas.
Good morning, everybody. Carol, thank you for that warm introduction. When I was asked to speak this morning, I was very humbled. I offer a 360-degree view of how the CFC can impact a family. As a Marine transitioning to the United States Postal Service, I learned giving was instrumental to giving back to our community. Little did I know, a few years later, in 2013, I would be depending on many of the charities listed in the CFC book. These CFC charities have impacted mine and my family's life so much that not only did we support, not only are we volunteers, but we also started a charity and joined the CFC. In just a moment, you're going to see my sad, humble story. But I want it to be an encouragement to each and every one of you that we are being the face of change, that every small gift can be multiplied and go a long way. I know that COVID has really thrown a curve in the way that we conduct these kickoff trainings and the way that we can interact. But I want to thank you. Thank you for taking time out of your day. Thank you for taking time out of your life. And thank you for supporting the CFC.
Shortly after January of 2013, we found out that Mindy was pregnant. And we had always wanted to expand our family, so I didn't think that that was too big of a deal. Their news was, you're going to have twins.
Their news was shocking.
And they saw something wrong with baby A, and that was Marissa. They hurried up and grabbed Marissa and was ready to take her from us to go to Cleveland Clinic Children's because she was labeled medically fragile. So this was our first roundabout with what medical fragile meant, what it looked like.
And through all of our ups and downs, and her first heart surgery was done well, and it gave us an extra 18 months with her, and to finally have this little girl who was full of smiles.
Set. Go. Love you.
Through all of her pain and suffering, that she came out and was the happiest baby that I'd ever met.
Say bye, Papa.
Papa.
We went almost six months from the time she was born to the time she was discharged, and we knew that a big open heart surgery was around the corner.
Careful with the baby. That's your baby. Yeah. Gonna lay the baby down to go night-night? Thank you.
And Dr. Hirsch shuffles back into the room and says to us, have you ever heard of Marissa's PDA becoming obstructed? And I almost turned ghost white. I said, yes, I've heard of that. We were told if that happens, it could be fatal. And And we avoid that at all costs. And he looked Mindy and I in the eyes and he said, her PDA is 100% obstructed.
Okay, go sit down. Sit on your butt. Thank you.
He said you could look at this in two ways, either a ticking time bomb or a blessing. And we told him that we choose the latter.
Very good, baby girl.
Good job.
How are you going to do her front?
There you go.
There you go.
You're doing great.
Good job.
So we fast forward 3 weeks, and Marissa stops breathing at home. We would write down everything that we prayed for, that we needed, notes regarding her care plan. And little did we know that this would be something, a tool, that would be so much bigger. Doctors Anna and Nelson Salto, which were an integral part of our family care, of the patient family experience, who took care of us, who loved on us, who brought us food, love, lodging, moved, bought a house to accommodate us so that we would have somewhere to stay and not have to incur the hotel cost. This was the blueprints for Marissa's mission. Surgeons decided they had to do something. Doing nothing would give us only 30 days with Marissa. And we had to make that tough decision to say, let's do another heart surgery. 2 days later, Marissa's new heart could not be sustained by her lungs and body. And we were quickly called into a conference room, a cold, cold conference room, to go over the results of her brain scan, at which time they told Mindy and I that our daughter was brain dead, that without life support, she would not live. No, we called in everybody, and basically we knew the severity that unless God performed a huge miracle, we would be saying goodbye to our daughter on November 13th, 2015. At 6:10 p.m. on November 13th, Marissa crossed into heaven.
My name is Gabe Forte, and I am a loan executive for CFC Zone 28 on loan from DFAS Cleveland. Before we introduce our next charity, we have a trivia question to ask. In what year was the combined federal campaign created? Please send your answers to gabe.forte@ohiocfc.org, and the first correct response that we receive will receive a free code for a digital movie rental provided by Fandango Now. Note that the responses will have to be done during this presentation. So if you happen to see this video at some point in the future, sorry, but you're out of luck. They have to be sent in live. Now, I would like to introduce you to our next charity, Providence House. Located in Cleveland, Ohio, Providence House is Ohio's first and one of the nation's longest currently operating crisis nurseries. They offer free, voluntary, non-custodial emergency shelter to children ranging from newborns through 12 years old, actively living in crisis situations, which place them at risk of abuse or neglect. And to date, they've served over 8,000 children and families, living in crisis. Providence House offers a comprehensive service called Crisis Nursery Program, which is focused on child abuse prevention and family preservation. Based on the latest industry research and evidence-based programs and practices, the program aims to help prevent child abuse and neglect and reduce foster care placements. Following the children's stay and receipt of intensive services provided at Providence House, said children are going home to stronger, more stable families. Over the last 5 years, an average of 98% of children served were reunited with their parent or guardian. Next, we will show a video narrated by their CEO and president, Natalie Leek Nelson. Take it away.
Welcome to Providence House. We are a multi-gen program focused on keeping kids safe and families together. We provide emergency shelter to children newborn to 12 years old whose families are experiencing crisis. Children stay with us for up to 90 days while we work intensively with family members and parents to safely stabilize the family and reunite their children. We really want to provide a safe, fun haven for children and allow kids to just be kids while their families work through the crisis that has brought them instability. Our program really works. 99% of our children are safely reunited with their families after receiving services. Thank you for helping our babies and children.
What a great video from Providence House. As you can see, there are many charities that you can support, and this was just a small sampling. As we prepare to end our kickoff today, I'm going to kick it back over to my colleague Orlando.
Thanks to each of you for your support to this year's campaign. And thanks to many of you for your continued support throughout the years. Let's do this. Show some love. Be the face of change.